Hello students, welcome back to our chapter Power Sharing. We are continuing its series. Now we have done two case studies of Belgium as well as of Sri Lanka, and we looked at the problem of the people, that if people are not happy in the country, so what it led to and what are the reasons behind that people are not happy, because power, political power in the country is not shared among them equally. Majority is trying to dominate minority. Somewhere minority, those who are rich and having more power politically, are trying to dominate majority as well. So the next topic, after doing those case studies, we are moving to the third one, which is called why power sharing is desirable. So that means now question comes to us in mind, after seeing both the case studies, why should we have power sharing, why it is desirable, why it is required to live in a democracy and to live in a harmony with all the people, irrespective their caste, creed, religion, race, language, culture, whatever. So those who are living in the country should feel that they are happy living in the country. So why power sharing is desirable? We have two sets of answers for that. One is based on prudential reasons, and other is based on moral reasons. So what is prudential reason? Prudential means based on calculation, and moral means based on values. Now tell me one thing. Let us start from the moral values, as it will be easy to understand what are the moral reasons to share power. We have learned so many moral stories in our childhood. Why did we learn them? Because every story teaches us one value. So this is a base of every life or every human being's life, that one should share whatever he or she has. So if we talk about sharing power in a political manner as well, so this is our moral reasons, and these are the values which teaches us that we should share. Okay, if you go to the NCRT, you will come to know that this is given in your paragraph, that democratic country should share their power, reason being because it affect all the people, those who are under this, I mean to say, those who are living in the country, affect them. So if we don't share the power, so it will affect their lives in a negative way. If we start sharing them morally and based on the values, so it helps the others also living happily. That will not bring any problem to the majority as well. So it is very important to share power on the grounds of moral values or moral reasons. Next set of reasons why should we share power is prudential reasons. Prudential means based on calculation. Assume, let us take example of Sinhalese only. 74% were Sinhalese and 18% were the Tamils. Now there is 100 rupee in the country. If 74% people would try to fetch all the 100 rupee, then what will happen? These 18% are neglected. So if you calculate also in terms of the percentage of people living in the country, if you are 74%, take 74% na. Why do we want entire 100 rupee? Same way. So based on calculation, if you calculate also, so we should share things according to the ratio in the country, the whatever country we have. Okay, so it says that if we do not share power, so it brings lot of conflict among the communities. So conflict will of course lead to the civil war, or you can say any kind of a disruption in the functioning of the country. So it leads to destruction, which we should avoid in any manner, right? And one more thing, will of majority means if you'll only think of majority people, will bring ruin to the minority as ruin to them as well in long run. So that means jaise cheeti hai ek haathi ko pareshan kar sakti hai uske soon mein ghus ke, so that means kai bari agar hum minority people ko neglect kare ye soch ke ki bahut chote hain ya ignore kare, so this is not right as well. So that brings ruin to the majority as well. So there are two sets of questions here, reasons that we should share power. So here goes your main important question of this lesson. Why should we share power? This is a direct question being asked in boards and very, very important, because after doing both the case studies, it is very normal that you are being asked, what did you learn out of these two stories of Sri Lanka and Belgium? So we have done this. This is a major third section of this lesson. We will move on to the next section in the next video. Thank you.